Good morning, I am Kiran Raj. Welcome to the online classes on problem solving using C. Today, we will be discussing about fourth part of the constants, variables and data types. In this class, we will see about the different input and output operations. Streams, sequence of characters organized into lines is called as streams. ANSI C supports lines of at least 254 characters. Now let us see how the input or output or error is tackled in your C program. The input to the C program can be given from the any input devices. It can be mouse, it can be keyboard, or it can be file, or it can be anything, any input devices. But mainly the input will be given from the keyboard, so your standard input device will be keyboard. While coming to the output also, output can be displayed or shown in the screen, or it can be stored in the file, or it can be using any output devices. But most of the time the standard output device that is used is screen or your monitor. Standard error, you can store them, that is error statements, in the file, or you can display them. So mainly it is displayed on the screen, so your standard error device will be screen or your monitor. Formatting output with printf. Printf is mainly used to display the things, whether it can be display the statement, display the string, or display the value, or display the output. It is just used to display the things. The format is printf. Then you have the format control string followed by the arguments. Here arguments, it can be one argument or the more arguments. Then closing with the semicolon. The control, format control string, it describes the output format, and it can have conversion specification, it can have flag, it can have strings, it can have field width, it can have precisions. That is format control string. It can have conversion specification, flags, field widths, strings, precisions. And while coming to the arguments, arguments correspond to each conversion specification in the format control string. It is not compulsory that you have to have the arguments, but in certain cases you want to display output of certain value, or you want to make some calculation, that time, depending on the conversion specification, you should have the arguments. Each conversion specification begins with percentage sign and ends with conversion specifier. What do you mean by conversion specifier? The conversion specifiers are mainly denoting the data, different data or different values. For example, if I am saying integer, then percentage D, that is D is the conversion specification, percentage D, that is used for the conversion, right? Input string or output string is converted to integer there, right? Okay. For example, if I am having percentage F, that means I am having one argument is of float type, and I am specifying that I am going to display the floating point value, and I am going to convert my string to floating point or any other type. It can perform rounding off, aligning columns, right or left justification, inserting literal characters, exponential format, hexadecimal format, fixed width and precision. So you can round off the value also, you can align the column, so which we'll be seeing later, and you can have the right justification or the left justification. You can have the literal characters, you can have the exponential format, that is E. You can display the output or print the statement using the hexadecimal format or the binary format or the octal format. you can have the fixed width and the precision for the output that you want to display or the value that you want to display. Conversion specifier D, that means it is going to display the decimal integer. I, again it is going to display the decimal integer, but the only difference you can see that in the scanner. The difference is when you are having the D, it is going to take the values or display the values in the base of 10. But when you are speaking about I, it will display the value in the base of 10. But when it is accepting the values, in the scanf statement, it is going to accept the values, right? So during that time, it is going to accept the values depending on the base value. For example, if it is octal, then it is going to take the value as the octal number. If it is hexadecimal, then it is going to take the value as hexadecimal number. So the importance is given to base here. But when you are speaking about D, whatever the number may be, but it is going to take it under the base value of 10. O, if you want to display the octal integer. U, if you want to display the unsigned decimal integer. X or capital X, if you want to display the hexadecimal numbers. H or L, that is short and long, they are the used for displaying the short and length. And during the scanf statement, where you want to accept the data, the same conversion specifier is used. Instead of display, you are just going to say that I am going to insert, right? That much is only the difference. For example, D, that means I am going to accept signed decimal integer. I am going to accept signed decimal integer, but while coming to here, depending on the base value. O, I am going to accept. So here, everything becomes accept here. So this is some of the example. So percentage D, I am mentioning I want to display 455. So 455 got displayed. And here, 455, again percentage I, decimal value only. So 455. And even though D and I are signed decimal number, but by default, the sign of the positive number is not displayed. 455, that is going to be displayed, minus 455. And if you see here, I'm displaying unsigned number, but I'm having 455. So it is going to convert it and it is going to display it. Okay. Then X here, X, that means hexadecimal number. So it is going to convert 455 into hexadecimal number. And here again the X is there, but capital X. So it is going to display the hexadecimal number of 455. The only difference between the capital letter X and the small letter X is this one. In the hexadecimal notation also, that is A, B, C, D, E, F, they are going to be present in small letter if you are using small letter X. But if you are going to use the capital, then they are going to be in the capital letters. In the same manner, I have the O here, that means octal. So 455 is converted to octal number, that is 707. Okay. And here, LD, that means I can store up to this much number and I can store that value, right? And here also, same manner, HD, that is short number, the capacity is around 32,000. Floating point number, F, is going to print the at least one digit of the decibel. So it is going to have the percentage F, or F is used to display the floating point number. You can use the E also, but when you are using E, it is going to have your exponent value, that is E. Mantissa E is going to come in your output or in your input, okay? And G, or capital G, it is going to be working similar to floating point only, but if any zeros are there, that is any trailing zeros are there, it is going to cut off those trailing zero values. For example, if I am having 1.2300, it is going to end with 00, right? So it is going to cut off. While coming to F, you can have the 6 precision point, right? In the same manner, you can have the double, where you can have the 12 precision point, and while coming to the long double, you can have the 15 precision point. Okay, so value becomes more accurate. So this is the sum of the value. So I mentioned here e, that means it is going to have exponent, this one mantissa e or exponential e in your output or in your input. So I am having e here, so I am converting this one. Here it will be converted to 1.234568 e plus 006 here. So it is going to convert it like that. Okay. How it is 6, you may get the confusion. How it is 6, just check here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 is there. 7 digits are there, right? On the left hand side, right? So what I am going to do? One point. Next, how many characters? 6 characters are going to be there. So what I am going to write? I am going to write 1.234567 or 68, because I am rounding off the number here. 0.89 I can convert into 8, right? So I am rounding off, and then I am going to write plus e plus 006. 10 to the power 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 10 to the power 6. So e plus 006. Here again, in the float also, if the number is positive number, it is not going to display them. It is only going to display them when you are going to have the negative number. Okay. So here also you can see that I am again rounding off the number, to 6, 7, 2, 6, 8. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? So 10 to the power 6, that is e plus plus 006. And I have the float here. Yeah, I already mentioned float means you are going to have the 6th precision point. So you can see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If you use g, it is going to take out the trailing zeros, okay? And when you have the g, if it is very longer number, it is going to use the e, okay, exponential. Pretty strings or characters. C, you are going to have the similar to F or D. You are going to have C here. That is used to print the character argument. And it can be only used to print the character. You cannot use that to print the strings. So if you want to print the strings, then what are you going to need? You are going to have the conversion, that is S there. So while coming to the strings is going to have the characters followed by the null character, that is slash 0. So you are going to have them. For example, the character is always enclosed with the single quotation and it is not going to have the null character. But while coming to the string, it is going to be enclosed with the double quotation and the end of the string is pointed by the null character. Some other conversion specifier, P, it is used to display the address value. N is going to have the number of characters that is outputted by the current printf statement. But let us say that you are having some errors in the printf statement and that printf statement did not work. Then what will be the value? I am going to have the negative number. I am going to have the positive number. If it is successful, and positive number means what? It is going to have what is the number of characters that was printed or that was present in the current printf statement. And let us say that you want to print percentage. How to print the percentage? Similar to escape sequence, you can use 2%. That term, it 1% sign will be printed. At the beginning of this class, we have seen that you can round off the values, or you can align the values, or you can align the display statement, or we can also mention that you can provide the field width or the precision, right? So we will see that here. What do you mean by field width? Size of the field in which data is printed is the field width. If the width is larger than the data, default, right? Justified. So if the width is larger than the data, then no problem. For example, I mentioned 10 space, that is 10 is my field width, and let us say that I want to print the value of only 5 width, then no problem, it is going to be fitted in that particular space that is provided, and by default it is going to be right justified. Okay, if field width is too small, and let us say that I have given only 5 width spaces, and but the output is of 10 space, then what it is going to do? It is going to neglect the field width that is provided, and it is going to display the proper output. If the width is larger, for example 10 width, and I want to use only 5 width spaces, then 5 width spaces will be used, and the remaining 5 is remains as it is, but it is wasted, but it will remain as it is. But when the field width is provided smaller and you have the larger data, then what it is going to do? It is going to be, even though the size width is provided smaller, it is going to display the proper or the exact output only. It is not going to compromise there. Okay. Minus sign uses one character position in the field. Integer width, instead of the integer field width inserted between the percentage and the conversion specifier. The example is given here. Percentage D is your conversion specifier, right? So what I'm going to do, or the actual thing you are going to use in printf statement or any scanf statement. But what you are going to do here, I am going to insert the field width here, that is integer number in between them. So that time what will be given? That time 4 width spaces will be provided for that integer value. D means what? D means integer value, right? It is going to display the integer value. So it is going to give the 4 width spaces. Now let us come for the precision. Precision means what? Decimal point. So how many precision or how many decimal point you want to print? So what you are going to do, you are going to use the dot operator. So dot, then followed by the integer number. Okay, it is similar to your field width only. How to use it? Again, they are going to be in between your percentage and the conversion specifier, but you are going to have dot. So now I have mentioned dot to 3, that is decimal point 3. That means I am only going to print the 3 decimal point. I am going to print 3 decimal point. I am not speaking about whole number. Whole number is completely printed. Okay, but decimal point, how much is printed? It is going to print only 3. For example, let us consider this one. 10,000.12345. That time 10,000.123 will be printed. Okay, you can use them together also with the field and field width and the precision. That time you are going to have the percentage, width, decimal point, precision, followed by the conversion specifier. So it is going to have both the things, that is field width also and the precision also. Now reading the data from the keyboard, you can assign the values to any variables using the assignment operator, but you can read the data from the keyboard also. So how to do that? You are going to use the scanf function. So scanf formatted control string followed by the arguments, that is variable 1, variable 2, variable 3, if I am having more than one argument, right? Okay, but the printf and the scanf, they are similar. The only difference is you are going to have the ampersand in front of the variable, so it is going to show that you are going to store the values in the memory address of the particular variable. For example, I am going to store the value in the memory address of variable 1. I am going to store the value in the memory address of variable 2. Okay. And another thing, you are not going to have any strings here. You are going to have the conversion specifier. Okay. The ampersand symbol, and before each variable name is an operator that specifies the variable name's address. So I am specifying variable 1's address. Okay. Example, scanf, percentage D, and number. So percentage D, that means I'm going to take the integer value from the keyboard and I'm going to store them in the number. Where the number is present, I'm going to store the integer value. Okay. The conversion specifiers of the printf are applied here also. D, that is integer number. I, again integer number, but the importance is given to base value. O, octal. P, pointer value. C, character. S, string. H, short. L, long. F, float. Okay. So they are going to be same here also. The field, width and the precision are also going to be applied here. I can have the field width for the character or for the, sorry, for the string also. Okay. For example, if I'm going to have the percentage 5s, that means I can only take 5 characters from the keyboard for that particular variable where I'm going to store it. Right. Okay. And we will try every examples done here in our practical sessions. Okay. Don't worry about that. We will understand the formats and syntaxes more there in the practical classes. Thank you.